Churn acts as an invisible hand pressing down on your app's growth. It puts a ceiling on how much subscription revenue your app can earn. If you have a high churn rate, that's gonna be a pretty low ceiling. And vice versa, if you have a low churn rate, you can have a pretty high ceiling. Let's talk about what churn is and how you can combat it so it doesn't squish your app's growth. The super simple definition of churn for a subscription business is the amount of revenue or subscribers you lose for a given time frame. Now, the most common time frame is monthly, but you can track churn daily, weekly, yearly. Churn can also be measured on individual subscribers or total revenue. Total revenue is typically the better way to do it, and that's because a lot of the time, each individual subscriber isn't worth the same amount. For example, if you have a $5 plan and a $20 plan for your product, well, it's pretty obvious the $20 user is gonna be more valuable than the $5 user. So if you're tracking individual subscribers, it's not gonna be super accurate. That's why you wanna measure total revenue to get the big picture.
Today's video is sponsored by Glassfy.
Here's a quick example. Let's say your app is earning $1,000 of monthly recurring revenue, but every month, due to cancellations, you lose $100 of that revenue. So your churn would be 10%. So 10% churn means that 90% of your revenue is renewing each month. Like that sounds great on the surface. Let's dive into that a little bit more and you'll see how the invisible hand of churn just squishes your app's growth. We'll continue with this 10% example. So your app is earning $1,000 monthly recurring revenue. So at 10% churn, you're gonna lose $100 of that each month. So all you have to do to overcome churn is get more than $100 worth of new users each month. That sounds doable. But when you're small, it's relatively easy to overpower churn just by pure growth. That's not the case as you continue to grow. So let's keep going with this. Okay, now you're at 10,000 MRR. Well, now you have to find $1,000 worth of new users every month. What about 100,000 MRR? Now you have to find $10,000 of new users every month. 1,000,000 MRR. Now you have to find $100,000 worth of new users each month just to break even. Like you can't grow until you do that. So as you can see, the more you grow, the harder it gets to grow. And that's what creates this curve that you see here. That's why it's that invisible hand like pushing you down. That's why your churn rate is so important. Because if you have a higher churn, well, that ceiling where you flatline, that's gonna be pretty low. But the lower your churn, well, now that ceiling is gonna be pretty high. So obviously you wanna strive for the lowest churn rate possible. Now, to be clear, this is a very simple example, a simple explanation. This is designed for people that aren't really familiar with the topic. Churn becomes very complex as you get some scale and you have millions and millions of users, bunch of different plans. It can be a pretty deep topic, but we're keeping it surface level right now. A slightly more advanced example of that basic churn we just talked about is segmenting your churn. Let's go back to that example where we had the $5 plan and the $20 plan, because you'll probably find some counterintuitive things. More often than not, the more expensive plan has way less churn than the cheaper plan. And that pretty much just boils down to price sensitivity. Typically, people that are paying the more expensive aren't that price sensitive. People that are paying cheaper are more price sensitive. That's a very broad generalization, but that's typically how it goes. But anyway, in the extreme example, if you track your churn for both the plans, and let's say you find the $20 a month plan has really great low churn, and the $5 a month plan, they're just churning like crazy. Like one drastic decision that could really change like the path of your product could be like, hey, why don't we just drop this $5 plan and only offer the $20 plan because that has way less churn and then you can build your product around those users. Again, that's a drastic example, but that absolutely can happen once you start segmenting your churn and seeing what's really going on for each plan. So how do you combat this horrible, terrible, no good churn? Well, having some level of churn is inevitable, right? You're not gonna create a product that no one ever cancels. But there are things you can do to minimize the churn as much as possible. The obvious answer that's way easier said than done is build a better product, make it stickier. Just build a product that people absolutely love to use and come back to. Because there's a lot of reasons why users may cancel, a lot of which are out of your control, like who knows what's going on in their life. But the one reason you can't control is when they say, this app sucks, or this app doesn't solve my problem, or this app is frustrating to use, it's buggy. So fix all that and you'll drastically reduce a whole subset of your cancellations, which will in turn reduce your churn. In turn, reduce your churn. We'll roll with it. Another thing you can do to reduce your churn is increase your average revenue per user. What this means is your existing users, find another way to make more money from them. So an obvious one might be, if you have that $5 plan and a $20 plan, find ways to convert those $5 people to the $20 plan. You know, that's again, increasing your average revenue per user. You could also raise prices, course, you got to be careful with that because you got to make sure the price increase, enough people are going to stick around to make up for the inevitable people that are going to leave due to a price increase. Or maybe you build your product with dynamic pricing in mind. Common example is Slack. Slack sells based on number of seats for a company. So if a company becomes a customer of Slack and they start small, as that company grows, maybe they go from 10 employees to 100 employees, well, they're going to need to buy more seats from Slack. So therefore, Slack's average revenue per customer is going to go up. That's just one example, but maybe that sparked an idea on how you can potentially build that into your product. Increasing your average revenue per user combats churn because your existing users, you're making more money from them, and that offsets the loss of people canceling. Now, can you imagine a scenario where your average revenue per user is growing so fast that it's growing faster than the number of people churning, the money you're losing each month? That's called net negative churn, and that is the dream scenario for anyone building a subscription product. So if you can pull that off, good for you. Enjoy the ride. Another way to reduce churn is to defend the cancellation. Now, you can get real creative on ways to win back your user, things that are unique to your app and your user base, but here's one example that will apply to almost all subscription apps. On the app stores, you can tell when the user goes in and turns off the auto renew. Now, this means they haven't canceled yet, but they're gonna cancel at their monthly renewal date, right? You've seen this when you go to cancel something. It's like, great, you're canceled. You'll get to use the service until, you know, June 14th, you know, when your next month comes up. So that is them turning off the auto renew. And a tool like Glassfy notifies me of this. Now, in my app creator view, I'm not collecting emails or any identifiable information. That was a choice I made, but most apps do collect some sort of email. So you can imagine when you get this notification that they turned off their auto renew and you have their email, this would be a great chance to win them back, whether that's offering them a discount or some perk in your app or whatever other type of win back idea you can come up with. This is a great chance to do it. So when you take somebody that was about to cancel and bring them back into a paying user, you are reducing churn by doing that. And speaking of Glassfy, I want to thank them for sponsoring today's video. Knowing when your users turn off auto renew, tracking your overall churn or segmenting your churn, as well as tracking your average revenue per user, this can all be done with Glassfy. Glassfy is a ridiculously flexible app revenue management platform that helps engineering and growth teams generate predictable revenue streams from their apps. Glassfy takes a platform approach with various solutions natively built in. I use them to implement that in CreatorView, my app, and the setup was a breeze. It also has revenue growth tools such as rich analytics, paywalls, and redemption codes so teams can use data to make better decisions to generate revenue all within the Glassfy platform. So whether you're adding revenue to an existing app or replacing your current setup, Glassfy will help engineering and growth teams deliver better on their revenue growth goals.